हेलो फ्रेंड्स, माय सेल्फ दीपक एंड वेलकम टू माय चैनल ऑनलाइन एजुकेशन पॉइंट। तो फ्रेंड्स, जैसा कि हम जानते हैं कि जितने भी ऑर्गेनिज्म जो भी प्रेजेंट है अर्थ पे, उसे क्या क्या किया गया है कि डिफरेंट डिफरेंट किंगडम्स में डिवाइड किया गया है। तो इसके लिए बहुत से साइंटिस्ट जो हैं उन्होंने क्या किया, अपना अपना किंगडम सिस्टम दिया। जैसे कि हम बात करें अगर टू किंगडम सिस्टम, थ्री किंगडम सिस्टम, फोर किंगडम सिस्टम, फाइव किंगडम सिस्टम एंड सिक्स किंगडम सिस्टम। तो क्या जितने भी साइंटिस्ट हैं उन्होंने क्या किया है, कुछ इंपॉर्टेंट पॉइंट्स या क्राइटेरिया को लेकर इन सब ऑर्गेनिज्म को जो भी अर्थ में प्रेजेंट है उन्हें डिफरेंट डिफरेंट किंगडम्स में क्लासिफाई किया है। ओके, तो आज हम पढ़ेंगे टू किंगडम सिस्टम के बारे में। तो इसे प्रपोज किया था लिनियस ने इन 1758। ओके, तो इट हैज गिवन बाय लिनियस इन 1758। ही इज आल्सो नोन एज फादर ऑफ टैक्सोनॉमी। ओके, सो ही हैज डिवाइडेड टू किंगडम सिस्टम इनटू प्लांटी एंड एनिमेलिया। ओके, तो दिस टू किंगडम सिस्टम इट हैज बीन डिवाइडेड इन टू किंगडम्स। फर्स्ट वन इज प्लांटी एंड अनदर वन इज एनिमेलिया। Okay, now the question comes that on the basis of what criteria he has divided into two kingdoms, okay, like Plantae and Animalia. So the basis of criteria is, the first one is on the basis of cell wall, okay, and the second one is on the basis of photosynthesis capacity. Okay, so Linnaeus, so what criteria he has used? So he has used two criteria. The first one is on the basis of cell wall, okay, and the second one is on the basis of photosynthesis capacity. Okay, so all the plants including bryophyte, tidophyte, gymnosperm, angiosperm, bacterias, like he has like classified all the organisms which is having the cell wall and which have the ability to do photosynthesis have been placed in the kingdom Plantae, while the others like the different arthropods, cnidaria, mollusca, echinodermata, all these have been classified into the kingdom Animalia. Okay, so now we will see the differences between the plant and animals, okay, so that we can be clear that why he has kept into two kingdom system like Plantae and Animalia, and what are the differences on the basis of what he has classified all the organisms into two kingdoms. Okay, so there are some points on the basis of that we will differentiate between the plants and animals. So plants, animals. So the first point is that plant is having cell wall, okay, and the cell wall is made up of cellulose. Okay, what is second in case of plant? Plants are autotrophic, means they have the capability to produce their own food with the help of photosynthesis. Okay, next one is chlorophyll is present, means how can they prepare food? So for that it requires chlorophyll, okay, and whatever the color you are like seeing in the plant, so that color is because of chlorophyll. Okay, that's why like mostly plant whatever you have seen it is of green in color, so chlorophyll is the pigment, because of that or the green color comes. Okay, next important is central vacuole is present. Next one, food is stored in the form of starch. Okay, so after doing photosynthesis, then the food is generally stored in the form of starch. Next, they are immobile means they don't have any locomotive organs. Okay, so just they can't move from one place to another place. Next is no sensory organs. No excretory organs. No nervous system. And the important one is slow response. Okay, slow response means when you will touch the plant, then its response to the external stimuli will be very slow as compared to the animals. Okay, so these are some points through which we can differentiate between the plants. Okay, now we'll discuss about the important properties of the animals or the important, like how can we differentiate between the plants and animals. Okay, so first one is, in the animal, cell wall is absent, so there is only plasma membrane is there. So plasma membrane, or we can say cell membrane, is present. Okay, plasma membrane is present. Here the plants are autotrophic, but here they are heterotrophic means for their food they have to depend on the others. Like some plants are carnivorous, some are omnivorous, some are herbivorous. Like if they are herbivorous, then they have to depend on the plants, because their food they can get from the plant. If he is carnivorous, then they have to depend on some other animals through which they can obtain their food. So they are heterotrophic. No chlorophyll present, because they don't do photosynthesis. So no chlorophyll. Central vacuole. No central vacuole is present. No central vacuole. Next, in the plant, food is stored in the form of starch. But in case of animal, is stored in the form of glycogen. Okay, then the plants are immobile, but in case of animal, they have locomotory organs. Are present, so they can move from one place to another place without any hindrance. In plants, no sensory organs. Here, sensory organs are present. In plants, no excretory organs, but in animals, excretory organs are present. Similarly, in plant, no nervous system. In animals, nervous system well developed. And the last point is slow response. Mean the plants, they respond very slowly. Here the fast response. So in animals, if we touch the animals, then they will react very fast. Okay, so their response is very fast when you touch the animals. Okay, so these are some of the important difference between the plants and animals. Okay, now we will discuss about the objections, or we can say limitation, because of that this two kingdom system has been failed. Okay, so we will discuss about the limitations. Okay, so we will discuss about the objections, or we can say limitations. Okay, so why this two kingdom system has been failed? So the first one is fungi. So this classification system, this two kingdom system, is not been able to place a fixed position for fungi. Okay, because this fungi, its cell wall is made of chitin, but mode of nutrition is heterotrophic. Okay, so cell wall, it fulfills the Plantae criteria and it fulfills Animalia criteria. Okay, so cell wall, it's a characteristic of the plant. Okay, because that it should be fixed, it should be placed in the kingdom Plantae, but it is having the mode of nutrition is heterotrophic, means it has to depend on the other for their food. So it fulfills the criteria Animalia. Okay, so it shows the character of both plants and animals. Okay, so its position is not fixed. Okay, it can show the character of both Plantae also and Animalia also. ठीक है, so अब हम बात करेंगे second one is lichens. So as we know, these lichens, they show symbiotic relationship between algae and fungi. Again, there is no fixed position for the lichens also in the linnaeus two kingdom system, because it show the character of both algae and also the fungi. Okay, that's why this kingdom system has been failed. Next point is position of prokaryotes. Okay, so prokaryotes, they don't do photosynthesis. Except some, for example, blue-green algae, or we can say the cyanobacteria. Okay, so the position of prokaryotes is also not fixed in this linnaeus two kingdom system, because some prokaryotes, they have the ability to do photosynthesis, but mostly they don't have the capacity to do photosynthesis. Okay, so blue-green algae, which is also known as cyanobacteria, it has a tendency to do photosynthesis. So the prokaryotes, the position of prokaryotes also is not been fixed in the linnaeus two kingdom system. So next, what? First formed organism. Okay, so the first formed organism, Linnaeus didn't describe anything about the first form organism, yani ki first animals or plants. Okay, who was present when the life started on the earth. So he didn't describe anything about the first formed organism. Next is Euglena. Okay, Euglena. So Euglena, the position of this Euglena has also not fixed in the Linnaeus two kingdom system, because when you see the structure of this Euglena, so what you will do, like, see, this is a flagella and this is chloroplast. Okay, so this Euglena, it shows the characteristic of both the plants as well as animals. Like, the presence of flagella shows the animal's character, animalia character, while the presence of chloroplast is shows about the plant character. Means with the when the light will be present, then this Euglena, it can conduct the photosynthesis reaction and then use the starch as a food. Or we can say then, in the presence of light, this Euglena, it has the capability to do photosynthesis. Okay, so the position of this Euglena is also not fixed in the Linnaeus two kingdom system. Okay, so these are some objections or the limitations. Okay, because of that, this Linnaeus two kingdom system has been failed. So friends, the video is now finished. So in the next video, I will discuss about the three kingdom system and the four kingdom system, and what are the criteria on the basis of what these scientists, they have classified the all the organisms into different kingdoms. Okay, so in the next video, I will explain about the this three kingdom system and the four kingdom system. So friends, if you like the video, then please subscribe my channel. Okay, so in the next video, we will meet. Okay, thank you. Dhanyavaad.